Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Okay, students, so I am going to continue explaining S hydrograph. So S curve is also known as S hydrograph, which is produced by infinitely continuous effective rainfall of 1 centimeter per hour or 1 inch per hour. So S hydrograph is nothing but hydrograph, direct runoff hydrograph from a catchment where the rainfall of 1 centimeter per hour is continuously falling. S hydrograph, we can get it by this unit hydrograph of any duration. Okay, for example, here unit hydrograph is given 1 centimeter per hour, or we can say that 1 hour unit hydrograph. Okay, so 1 hour unit hydrographs, they are lagged by 1 hour continuously. Then by adding the ordinates, we'll get the S hydrograph of 1 hour 1 centimeter per hour intensity. Look at here. So S hydrograph obtained as delta T HT plus ST minus delta T plus ST minus delta T, etc. So why we are multiplying with delta T is because here these unit hydrographs, they are of delta T duration. Okay, so since delta T duration, the intensity of unit hydrograph is 1 by delta T, but S hydrograph is always of intensity 1 centimeter per hour. So therefore, to get 1 centimeter per hour duration, 1 centimeter per hour intensity, we have to multiply the delta T. We have to multiply with delta T, because delta T is a duration of unit hydrograph used to derive S hydrograph. So S hydrograph is very useful, because if you know a higher order, higher duration unit hydrograph, and we need to derive a lower duration unit hydrograph, then we must use S hydrograph. So S hydrograph is used to develop lower duration unit hydrographs from higher duration unit hydrographs. And how we will derive a unit hydrograph from S hydrograph? Because suppose we need to derive, because we have a S hydrograph which is of intensity 1 centimeter per hour or 1 inch per hour, and we need to develop some theta d duration unit hydrograph. So what we have to do, we have to plot S hydrograph, and then we have to plot the second S hydrograph, the same S hydrograph but lagged by d duration. Okay, or here it is lagged by delta T prime duration. Okay, delta T prime. So we need to derive a unit hydrograph of delta T dash duration. So therefore, we are plotting two hydrographs, two S hydrographs with lagging of delta T prime. So the difference between these two S hydrographs, that gives GT minus G T minus delta T prime. Okay, but so whatever we are getting, that unit hydrograph that is of 1 centimeter per hour that is 1 hour duration, okay. But we need to derive unit vectorgraph of delta t prime duration. So therefore, we have to divide the difference between these two SI graphs by delta t prime. So therefore, we will get 1 by d intensity unit graph. So here again the same thing, how to obtain a different duration unit graph from SI graph. So first we have to develop SI graph, then we have to we have to plot the SI graphs with lagging time t, okay, and these SI graphs of duration d, and we need to derive unit graph of duration small t. Therefore, that is obtained as d star a minus b by t, where a is the SI graph starting from 0, b is the SI graph starting from lagged time, then d is the, that is the duration of unit graph used to develop this SI graph. Then the small t, that is the duration of unit graph needs to be developed. So using this formula, we'll get unit graph of different duration from SI graph. Now we'll do one example. Okay, we'll do one example. So here 0.5 hour unit graph is given. Okay, so first two columns, this is the input data. 0.5 unit graph, 0.5 hour unit graph is given, and we need to derive a SI graph. So remember, SI graph is always corresponds to 1 centimeter per hour or 1 inch per hour intensity. And whatever this unit graph is given, that is of a different intensity, because here the unit graph is given as, duration is given as 0.5 hour. That means the intensity is 1 by 0.5, that is 2 units per hour. And but to get the SI graph, we have to divide by that duration. The for example, here t is given and 0.5 unit graph ordinates are given. Okay, now we have to derive this SRS hydrograph ordinate. So how to derive this? Because first this 0.5 unit graph, that is to be lagged. So in the second column, so we have started 0 from 0.5 hour, then we have to get SI graph ordinate as 404 plus 0, that is 404. In next, because the second unit graph, that is lagging by 0.5 hour, therefore the next SI ordinate is equal to the second ordinate of first unit graph plus first ordinate of second unit graph, that is 1079 plus 404, that 1483 we have to keep it. And then we have to bring this 1483 here, because this 1483 is the summation of two ordinates. Now the third ordinate is 2343. Okay, so we have to add that two. So it is this 3826, that is nothing but u1 plus u2 plus u3. So here it is u1, here it is u2, u1 plus u2, and this 3826 is u1 plus u2 plus u3, and 6332 is u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus u4. So to calculate easily, what we have to do, we have to start this lagged unit graph by the duration of this unit graph, that is 0.5 hour, So we have to start from here. Then we have to add this 404 to 0. We'll get 404 here. And this 404, we have to take it here. So we can show it by inserting a one shape, okay. So that 404, we have to bring it here. Similarly, that 1483, again we have to bring it here. So 3826, again we have to bring it here. So finally, we'll get aside-to-graph coordinates. They are nothing but successive addition of these unit-to-graph coordinates, lagged by the duration of unit-to-graph. So now we have to, because this whatever the aside-to-graph coordinates we have obtained, they are of intensity 1 by 0.5. Okay, that means their intensity of 2 units per hour. But aside-to-graph is always of 1 unit per hour intensity. So therefore, we have to divide it by 2 units. Then we'll get this final column 0202741.5191. So here the aside-to-graph is of a unit intensity. That is, here the unit-to-graph units are not given. Unit-to-graph coordinates units are not given. So we'll assume as let us say centimeters. Okay, here. So this 0.5 unit aside-to-graph, we will assume it as, it is 1 centimeter rainfall in 0.5 hour. So therefore, the intensity is 2 centimeter per hour. And here the SH coordinates, they are of 2 centimeter per hour. But finally, we have to correct it to 1 centimeter per hour. So therefore, we have to divide this aside-to-graph by 2 units. Then we'll get aside-to-graph of 1 centimeter per hour. So this is a way to obtain aside-to-graph. Now, aside-to-graph can be used to derive unit-to-graph of different duration. So that duration can be smaller or larger than the given unit-to-graph duration. So for example, we'll go for next example here. Here the same unit-to-graph, that is 0.5 hour duration unit-to-graph. From this one, now we have to derive 1.5 hour unit-to-graph. So what this question is, we have been given a unit-to-graph of half an hour duration, but we have to derive unit-to-graph of 1.5 hour duration using aside-to-graph. So first thing is, in this problem, first thing is we have to develop a aside-to-graph of 1 centimeter per hour intensity. So that is already I explained, but I will explain it again here. So in the first two columns, time is given, then 0.5 hour unit-to-graph coordinates are given. Now we have to derive a S ordinate. So for that one, we have to lag the unit-to-graphs by the duration of unit-to-graph, that is 0.5 hour. So now here we are lagging unit-to-graphs continuously for every 0.5 hour. So that how we get it, by here at 0.5 hour, we are starting with second unit-to-graph. Now the cumulative ordinate is 404 plus 0, that is U2 plus U1, that is 404. Now we have to add U3. How can we do that one? This 404, we bring it here, then U3 is 1079, So that to be added to 404, that will get 1483. And now the resulting SH coordinate of intensity 1 by 0.5. But that is 2 units intensity. But SI diagram is always 1 unit intensity. So therefore, whatever this SRG ordinate we are getting, we have to divide it by 2 units, then we will get the SI diagram of 1 unit intensity. Now we have obtained SI diagram. Now using this SI diagram, we have to derive a 1.5 hour unit diagram. How we obtain that one? We have to now this next second SI diagram, that is to be lagged by 1.5 hour. That is lagged by 1.5 hour, then we have to find the difference between these two SI diagrams. But those SI diagrams, they will give one unit intensity, but the unit diagram we need to derive is intensity of 1 by 1.5. So therefore, we have to multiply that 1 by 1.5 of the difference between two SI diagrams, then we'll get the unit diagram of 1.5 hour duration. So here, so SI diagram is given in this column. Okay, now another SI diagram should be lagged by the unit diagram needs to be, the duration of unit diagram needs to be derived. So the unit diagram derived is 1.5 hour. So this SI diagram, it should be lagged. That means the zero starts with from 1.5 hour. So see 1.5 hour here. Okay, so the zero starts from here. Then you copy all these columns as it is from here onwards, like 20274. Just you copy this here, copy, and you paste it here. You paste it here. Then you will get all these rows. Now you separate this from this and divided by the duration of the unit diagram needs to be derived, that is 1.5. So here 0 minus 0 divided by 1.5, that is 0. 202 minus 0 divided by 1.5, that gives 134.7. 741.5 minus 0 divided by 1.5, that gives 494.3, and so on and so forth. We'll get the final ordinates for unit diagram of 1.5 hour. Okay. Now, so in this case, we have derived a unit diagram that is larger than the duration larger than the given unit diagram. But now, the most important thing, that is the most important application of SI diagram, is to derive a unit diagram lower than the given unit diagram. So for this one, this example is a best example. Now 4 unit unit diagram is given, and we need to derive 2 hour unit diagram. So for that one, we must use SI diagram. Okay, so always please note that the unit diagram, 4 hour unit diagram is given, and we need to derive 2 hour unit diagram. For this one, what we have to do, we have to get the ordinates of this 4 hour unit diagram every 2 hours. Supposing the question is given here, in the question is given the ordinates of 4 hour unit diagram every 4 hours, but we have to do interpolation and we have to get the ordinates for every 2 hour interval, because we need to derive a 2 hour unit diagram from 4 hour unit diagram. So by interpolation, we obtained this 4 hour unit diagram every 2 hour interval. Okay, now the second thing, we have to get the S hydrograph. So further, what we have to do, because this is a 4 hour unit diagram, so we have to lagged by 4 hours. So the second unit diagram that lags from 4 hours. Okay, So start 0 and 8. You copy 0 and 8 here. Then first you start with 0. Then 0 here also 0. 0 plus 0 it is 0. Then 8 plus 0 that is 8. Then 20 plus 0 20. Okay. Now we have obtained three values 0, 8, 20. So those the 8 and 20 values we have to bring it here. So this 8 and 20 we have to bring it to here. So now, once you copy this 8 and 20 here, then add them to this unit vector graph coordinates, then we'll get 51 and 100. Now, this 51, 100, we have to move it here. Then we'll get 161 and 230. So then you move it here. So it is very easy to do this calculation in Excel. Okay. So finally, we have got hydrograph coordinates of intensity 1/4. Okay, now we need intensity of 1 unit, so therefore we have to multiply that with 4. Then finally we will get S hydrograph of 1 centimeter per hour duration intensity. So this is the S hydrograph we have got it for this given 4 hour unit hydrograph. Now we need to derive a unit hydrograph of 2 hour duration. So therefore we have to plot another S hydrograph lagged by 2 hours, and that is given in the second column. Okay, what we are doing, we are copying the same column of this S hydrograph but lagging by 2 hours. Okay, so once we copy the same here, then you find the difference between these two columns, but they are of duration 1 centimeter per hour, but for 2 hour unit hydrograph the intensity is 1/2, that is 0.5. therefore we have to multiply with 0.5 of the difference between these two columns. So 32 minus 0 into 0.5, that given 16. 18 minus 32 into 0.5, that given 24. So 204 minus 80 into 0.5, that gives 62. So finally we have got our 2 hour unit hydrograph from 4 hour unit hydrograph. So this is the main application of S hydrograph. So next important thing is synthetic unit hydrograph. Okay, so
sir, in the previous example once.
Okay, so do you need explanation again,
like how did we get the 2 hour plot? First one, 0 to 4, like we have only times of 4 multiples.
We need to do linear interpolation. Okay, or we have to do what so you can do is that on a graph sheet we have to plot a unit hydrograph of 4 hour duration. Okay, and sure. Then for every 2 hours, for every 2 hour interval, we have to get that intermediate values. That is the best way to do it, and otherwise you can go for simply linear interpolation. Okay, suppose here the slope is 20/4, that means 5 units per hour. So for 2 hours it becomes 10. Okay,
sure.
But here instead of 8 it will become 10. But anyway, that because since unit hydrograph is not linear, okay, it is a rising limb which is a curve, and a cone that is also a curve, and recession limb is also a curve, it is not linear. But if you don't have a graph sheet, we can go by linear. or otherwise if you are
so
still
like
good in
sir here in case we got value as 10 but the given value is 8 it is because of the graph
yeah that is because of the curvature okay
okay
that's what see I mean for simplicity I am telling you to do linear interpolation but in like MATLAB if you use MATLAB there are many interpolation methods are there like spline cubic spline etc power etc so we can suppose if you use the cubic spline we will get 8 okay like if you go for higher order curves we'll get more accurate the intermediate values for in
yes.
any exam if you are given this kind of question simply you go for linear interpolation okay because you will not be having MATLAB or anything in exam so you can simply use linear interpolation okay so you are okay now
yes sir
okay so let's go for next synthetic unit retrograph see unit retrograph we derive it how we derive it first we'll get for any watershed which is a gauged watershed that means we know the rainfall in that watershed that means we have measured the rainfall using rainfall gauge rain gauges and as well as we have measured a stream flow at the outlet and from that we already I explained that how to derive a unit hydrograph once we know the hydrograph then we subtract base flow then we'll get direct rainfall hydrograph then we have to get the effective rainfall that is the volume of the water under the curve divided by area that gives effective rainfall and then the direct runoff hydrograph ordinates are divided by effective rainfall that gives unit hydrograph but in many cases because if you suppose a forest area need to be developed but in that area there may not be a precipitation gauges and as well as stream flow measurement or gauges so in that case since we don't have a unit hydrograph but we need to find a hydrograph because we need to construct some building there or bridge or something or a dam there in that case we have to use a synthetic unit hydrograph okay. So in the synthetic unit hydrograph because that is we will take the parameters of that watershed and as well as rainfall characteristics then we derive a unit hydrograph synthetically so synthetic unit hydrograph that is mainly for ungauged basins and further we need data from gauged basins because as I said although it is ungauged basin to develop a unit hydrograph still we need rainfall characteristics and watershed characteristics okay so those values we'll get it from similar gauged basins and you may be having a doubt about what is ungauged basin and what is gauged basin okay so ungauged basin is where there is no precipitation measurement devices and no stream flow measurement devices are available and so therefore there is no unit hydrograph available for that basin so that is a ungauged basin and gauged basin means so already it is a developed land so rainfall gauges are available and as well as stream flow gauges are available so already developed because you know if we develop a unit hydrograph any duration maybe 2 hours 4 hours 6 hours 10 hours if we have one unit hydrograph of some given duration then using SI hydrograph we can develop other unit hydrographs of different durations But for any basin, suppose we need to know the stream flow characteristics, that is hydrograph, we must know a unit hydrograph of any duration in that basin. So synthetic hydrographs, they are developed by relating hydrograph characteristics such as peak flow, base time, and with watershed characteristics. Okay, so watershed characteristics, the important watershed characteristics are area of the watershed and as well as time of concentration. So you know what is time of concentration, that I'll come to you later. And for rainfall, that stream flow characteristics, we need to know the peak flow and the rainfall duration and base time of the hydrograph. So combining this rainfall hydrograph characteristics with watershed characteristics, we'll derive some constants, and with those constants we'll get a synthetic unit hydrograph. And other way around is that this soil conservation service of United States, what they did, they normalized the unit hydrographs of many watersheds. Then they found out a universal characteristic. Okay, from that one they developed a unit hydrograph. Okay, so these two are mainly we are discussing in this class, synthetic unit hydrograph, that is derived from this watershed parameters and hydrograph characteristics, and second, synthetic hydrograph from dimensionless unit hydrograph. So there are mainly, there are, as I said, there are two important methods, Snyder method and SCS. SCS is abbreviation is Soil Conservation Service of United States of America. So these two are most popular methods to derive synthetic hydrographs, and they will be discussed in this class. So Snyder method, Snyder is a US scientist, okay, and in 1938 he studied many catchments in Appalachian mountains in United States. Okay, so Appalachian mountains, they are range of mountains in United States, so they are in South Carolina, North Carolina, and few more states. So he studied many watershed areas, watersheds in those areas, and developed some empirical equations to derive a unit hydrograph. Okay, so this equation is, since it is developed for United States, so it is in use in United States, but many other countries like India and other countries, they adapted it with small changes to those equations. Snyder method. So Snyder method is mainly based on time of concentration. So time of concentration is nothing but TP. So TP is the distance between centroid of the rainfall and centroid of the watershed. But since we have difficulty in finding centroid of watershed and centroid of this rainfall, what we do, TP is given simply as the distance between center of this rainfall hydrograph and peak of hydrograph. Okay, so that is given as TP. So this is the unit hydrograph measured. Now Snyder proposed this unit hydrograph, that is given on the right side. Okay, so here he has taken the rainfall hydrograph duration is T capital R, then the lag time or time of concentration, that is given as TP capital R, and the peak discharge, that is QP capital R. So totally six quantities, one is TR, T capital R, T, P capital R, then QP capital R, then this width of hydrograph, yet 50% of peak discharge and 75% of peak discharge. Okay, so widths are obtained, and then TB. So once these six quantities are computed, we can easily draw a hydrograph, that is synthetic unit hydrograph. So according to the Snyder, because ultimately the synthetic unit hydrograph that is obtained from a measured unit hydrograph, okay, and he developed this synthetic unit hydrograph from a standard unit hydrograph. So what is the meaning of standard is TPR, TP is equal 5.5 TR, that means the time of concentration is equal 5.5 times the duration of unit hydrograph. Okay, so if that condition is met, then the unit hydrograph is called as standard unit hydrograph, and simply that can be adapted for the adapted for synthetic unit hydrograph. But the TPR is not equal to TP is not equal to 5.5 TR, so then he has proposed some equations. Okay, so let's go in. Let us go to those equations. So in Snyder's method, there are totally four parameters that are important. So hydrograph parameters, that is TP and QP. TP is the time of concentration, okay, and then we can also TP also called as lag time. Then QP, that is peak flow of unit hydrograph. So these are two important parameters of hydrograph. Then two important parameters of watershed. They are called as basin parameters. They are denoted as CT and CP. Okay, so CP corresponds to lag time and CP corresponds to the peak flow. The CT, a larger CT means it is a the basin lag is higher, and larger CP means greater peak flow. So they represent okay, the CT that represents watershed slope and storage effects, whereas CP that represents retention and storage capacity of watershed. So CT and CP are basin constants. So CT represents the slope of the basin, whereas CP represents the retention capacity, that is storage capacity of the basin. So now this is just definition of lag time. Okay, so lag time is the difference between centroid of input and the output, and it is nothing but it is time of travel of water from all parts of watershed reaching the outlet. So or we can also call the lag time is the maximum time taken by the farthest point to reach the outlet. I mean the water flowing from farthest point to the outlet, the time taken by that is lag time.